Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord.
Yes, yes. Hallelujah.
Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that has made us and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good.
Yes.
His mercy is everlasting.
Yes, yes.
And his truth endures to all generations.
Yes, all yes. Generations. Hallelujah.
Oh. Hallelujah. Amen. I read Psalm 101 through 5. The word is already blessed.
Yes. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Father God in heaven, we come to you, Lord, on today just to invite you into your house.
Yes.
We come to you asking you, Lord, to have a seat with your people, Lord.
Yeah.
So that we can worship you, Lord, and to trust in your words and to understand of you, Lord, so that we can be better for you, Lord.
Yeah.
So right now, Lord, we ask you that you bless all the ones that are here, Lord,
yes,
the ones,
yes,
that are on their way, Lord. Yes. And we just ask you to bless the shepherd of this house,
bless,
Lord.
Lord.
Just continue to give him direction. Continue to give him the strength to
keep
going and teach your people, Lord. And so right now, Lord, we ask you that you come in.
Come in.
To have a seat, Lord.
Come in.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
We ask in your son, Jesus the Christ. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Oh. said, Hosanna to the King.
Yes, yeah.
Jesus came walking into or riding into Jerusalem 6 days before they would be saying, crucify him. Would you turn with me to the 12th chapter of the Gospel of John? And we'll read from there verses 1 to 19. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. John chapter 12, verse 1, beginning at verse 1 to verse 19. Got it? Amen.
Amen.
Give me a moment to get to it. Amen. John 12. Amen. Then Jesus, 6 days before the Passover, came to Bethany, where Lazarus had been dead, whom he raised from the dead.
There they made him a supper, and Martha served, but Lazarus was one of them that sat at his table with him.
Then took Mary a pound of ointment of spikenard, and very costly, and anointed the feet of Jesus, and wiped his feet with her hair. And the house was filled with the odor of the ointment.
Then said one of the disciples, Judas Iscariot, Simon's son, which should betray him.
Why was not this ointment sold for 300 pence and given to the poor?
This he said, not that he cares for the poor,
but because he was a thief
and had the bag and bare what was put therein.
Then said Jesus, let her alone, against the day of my burying hath she kept this.
For always ye have with you, but me ye have not always.
Much people of the Jews therefore knew that he was there, and they came not for Jesus' sake only, but that they might see Lazarus also, whom he had raised from the dead.
But the chief priests consulted that they would put Lazarus also to death.
Because that by reason of him many of the Jews went away and believed on Jesus.
On the next day, much people were gathered to the feast. Then they heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem.
Took branches of palm trees and went forth to meet him and cried, Hosanna, blessed is the King of Israel that cometh in the name of the Lord.
And Jesus, when he had found the young ass, said thereof, as it is written,
fear not, daughter of Zion, behold thy king cometh, sitting on an ass's colt.
These things understood not his disciples at first, but then when Jesus was glorified, they remembered that these things were written of him, and that they had done these things unto him.
The people therefore that was with him when he called Lazarus out of the grave and raised him from the dead bear record.
For this cause the people also met him, for they had heard that he had done this miracle.
And together?
The Pharisees therefore said among themselves, perceive ye how ye prevail nothing. Behold, the world is gone after him.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
with you like this. If you ever had somebody that you thought was with you, a friend, and they wound up turning their back on you, that you thought that they were with you and all of a sudden they were gone. Palm Sunday sort of reminds me of that. That as a people, you know, the children of Israel, many of them who were there when Jesus came down into Jerusalem, he had to come down to come into Jerusalem. He came, the Bible says, riding on a donkey. And kings usually rode on a stallion, on the big horse, you know, the symbol of power. But Jesus, who was the Son of God, came riding in on a donkey. And the fact that he did symbolizes in so many ways the humbleness of the King of Kings.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
All right. But when he came in, I just think about how Jesus, who knew so much, knew everything, as the Son of God, knew everything, could witness people strawing out palms as a sign of a king coming. Which is one of the things that they do. They would lay out their coats or lay out palm branches as a sign of the king coming. And in the midst of that, I just only imagine that Jesus looked and saw these faces of people who were celebrating and praising him and yet knew that he was on his way to die. And that some of the very people who were laying out palm branches celebrating him as king coming in would later be the people who would say, crucify him.
Come on, amen.
So
amen.
As that's why Palm Sunday means so much to me, because it reminds me to stay faithful to the Lord always and never put myself in a place of turning my back on him, because he has never, ever, ever turned his back on me.
Amen, amen, amen.
It is a great reminder, and that's why we have the palm branches. So when you take them home, don't just throw them over on the side because the day is over, but put them somewhere where you can just remember from time to time that we are called to be faithful. Whenever we think of the Lord.
Amen.
If you stand with me, I want to get ready to share a word from the Gospel of John, what we read on today. From the Gospel of John. And while you're finding yourselves in John again, the 12th chapter, and we'll be at the 12th verse through the 23rd verse today, share with me in our scripture verse.
Trust in the Lord with all thy heart, and lean not to thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path.
There. You got it. Say, I got it. If you're looking, say, I'm looking.
I got it.
Amen. Amen. I think I heard everybody's got it then. On the next day, much people that were come to the feast, when they heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem, took branches of palm trees and went forth to meet him and cried, Hosanna, blessed is the King of Israel that cometh in the name of the Lord. And Jesus, when he had found a young ass, sat thereon, as it is written, Fear not, daughter of Zion, behold thy king cometh, sitting on an ass's colt. These things understood not his disciples at the first, but when Jesus was glorified, then remembered they that these things were written of him, and that they had done these things unto him. The people therefore that was with him, when he called Lazarus out of his grave, and raised him from the dead, bear record. For this cause the people also met him, for that they heard that he had done this miracle. The Pharisees therefore said among themselves, Perceive ye how ye prevail nothing? Behold, the world is gone after him. And there were certain Greeks among them that came up to worship at the feast. The same came therefore to Philip, which was of Bethsaida of Galilee, and desired him, saying, Sir, we would see Jesus. Philip cometh and telleth Andrew, and again Andrew and Philip tell Jesus. And Jesus answered them, saying, The hour is come that the Son of Man should be glorified. This is the word of the Lord in your hearing.
Amen.
I shared with you the importance of Palm Sunday and why we share these palms, why we give palms out on this Sunday. It is to represent what Jesus has done, to represent and reenact, if you will, Jesus coming into Jerusalem. He had just raised Lazarus from the dead.
Yeah.
He had just performed one of the most powerful miracles that we could ever know. The raising of someone who had already expired from the dead. Not just a few moments after death, but 3 days after he had died.
Yeah.
And here he is sitting with his people, the disciples, those that have been with him, and he's sitting there, and Lazarus is sitting at the table. Bless you. And as Lazarus is sitting at the table, eating, by the way, eating, why does the Bible tell us that Lazarus was eating? Because they know that he was alive. Dead people don't eat.
Come on.
Lazarus was sitting at the table with Jesus, eating together.
Yeah.
And then Jesus decides it's time for me to go into Jerusalem. And so he has his disciples go get a donkey and a colt, one of the smaller donkeys. And so he comes riding in on this donkey. He rides in on the donkey, and the people are so excited about his coming. They have heard about the raising of Lazarus from the grave. They have heard about the healing of many of the people that Jesus has healed. He has restored the sight to the blind. He has made the lame to walk. He has done all these things. And people are excited because now he's coming into Jerusalem. The Savior, the King of Kings, is coming into Jerusalem. And they believe that this means something is getting ready to happen for the citizens of Jerusalem. And so they come out to hear this great preacher that they have heard so much about. And here's Jesus coming in humbly on a donkey. Not on a stallion, not on a great horse, not in a great chariot, but on a donkey. And some of us get worried about how we may be looking and embarrassed about how we look. And Jesus wasn't worried about how he looked. He didn't worry about it. That's what's important here. And so they took the palm branches and, you know, went and grabbed them off the trees and laid them before him as a symbol of his kingship.
And if you
were the person who get a big head, this would have been a good time for you to get a big head.
That's right.
Because people were coming and laying it down before him and celebrating him and crying out Hosanna to the King. Which is like praise the King who is coming, and blessed is the King who is coming in the name of the Lord. And they're doing all of this like you and I might do on a Sunday morning. Come in and praise the Lord and give him
all the praise.
And we might do that, and then, you know, we leave this place and we go do the things that we still want to do that is not like God.
Come on.
So we have this sense of what is going on, and the people are excited, and the children are excited, and parents are excited, and the men of Jerusalem are coming out because there's something happening when Jesus comes by. There's always something happening when Jesus comes by.
Amen.
But through this, 6 days from now, Jesus is going to be on the cross.
Giving
his life for you and I.
Amen.
While the Bible says, while we were yet sinners, he died for us. And yet the people cannot see it, but Jesus knows he is on his way to die. And so this is what I want you to remember. His triumph through tragedy.
That's
the title of my message. His triumph through tragedy. See in this passage that's important is people hear about Jesus through us.
Yes.
verse 12, on the next day,
yeah,
much people that were come to the feast, when they
heard
yeah,
that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem.
Amen.
There were people talking about Jesus all the way through and all the way on his way to Jerusalem. Uh-huh. People started talking about Jesus is coming.
Yeah.
Jesus is coming.
Yeah,
yeah, Rose, Jesus is coming. Bob and Rose, Jesus is coming.
Yeah.
They went and told somebody else, Darren, Jesus is coming.
Yeah.
Hey, you need to go tell somebody Jesus is coming. And people started, is that the one who was healing the sick,
yeah,
and making the lame to walk,
yeah,
and healing the blind,
yeah,
and making the blind to be able to see?
Yeah.
Is that the one that raised Lazarus,
yeah,
from the grave?
Yeah.
Jesus,
right,
is coming. I want to tell you, there's something going on.
Yeah.
You need to get over here and see it.
Yeah.
He's coming,
yeah,
in.
Come on, somebody, amen, amen.
Yeah.
And you need to be there.
Yeah.
Jesus is coming.
Yeah.
And God is looking for us to be the ones who would share and tell them, tell the people that he is now there,
yeah,
and that he is on his way,
uh-huh,
so that they know what to do.
Yeah.
But if the people are silent, they don't know Jesus.
Yeah. Amen. Amen.
If the people never open their mouth, they won't know who Jesus is.
Amen. Yeah.
If we never talk about who the Lord is,
yeah,
to somebody else, we won't be able to let somebody else know that Jesus still sings.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen.
And so this,
yeah,
this triumph through tragedy has its moment, its initial moment in the fact that people are excited about Jesus coming and they want to tell somebody else.
Yeah. Amen. 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 Amen.
So people hear about Jesus through us.
Yeah.
It's folk that want to just hand the Bible to somebody and go, hey,
yeah,
read this here. It'll tell you all you need to know.
Come on. Come
but
on.
That's not what Jesus is telling us to
do.
We need to be able to tell somebody. We need to be able to witness to somebody.
Yes.
Here we are 6 days out before Easter, and we need to be telling somebody, guess what? He rose. He got up.
Yes. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
And then 3 days later, he got up.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
If we don't tell somebody that Jesus is coming, then they won't know. And when we don't tell anybody, when we keep it to ourselves, there's something wrong with that. I'm excited that Jesus is
coming. Hallelujah.
I got to tell somebody.
Yeah.
It's like Jeremiah said, it's like fire.
Shut up
in my bones. It just won't leave me alone. I got to tell somebody.
Yeah.
Jesus is still around. Free
it.
Come on now. People hear about Jesus through us. That's the first thing that I see.
Yeah.
I see people, there were people all around. They said they had come for the feast. They came in for the feast. This was the Passover, the celebration of Passover.
Yeah.
So the people were there also because they were there to celebrate the Passover. But then they heard,
come on,
Jesus was coming themselves. They needed to line up to see who this great man was, who this king was. They wanted to make sure that something was known about who he was.
Yeah.
So it wasn't necessarily even his disciples that had told them because they were with Jesus. But somebody began to tell somebody, told somebody that Jesus is coming.
Yes, yes, yes.
Are you one of those somebodies?
Yes.
Are you telling people that Jesus is still coming?
Yes.
Are you telling them that Jesus still heals?
Yes.
Are you telling them that Jesus still can restore the sight to the blind?
Yes.
Are you telling them that Jesus made a way out of no way for you?
Yes.
Are you telling people what God has done for you?
Yes.
People need to hear about Jesus through us.
Yeah.
Yes.
Not only
people
need to hear about Jesus through us, but this passage also teaches us something else. That there are waves.
Amen.
For our King of Kings.
Yes, yes, yes.
The Bible records in John 12:13, it says, they took branches of palm trees and went forth to meet him and cried, Hosanna. Blessed is the King of Israel that cometh in the name of the Lord.
Yeah, amen.
Are you coming in the name of the Lord?
All right. Come on now.
Are you trying to tell somebody about Jesus?
Yes.
Do you represent Jesus in your life and lifestyle? Yes. Are you sharing with somebody else that I not only today did I get palmed to wave and let you know that Jesus was coming and this is what they did?
Yeah.
This is the wave for our King of Kings.
Amen, amen, amen.
Some people don't have to necessarily wave palm branches.
Amen.
Some people raise their voice and say hallelujah.
Yeah, yeah.
Some people raise their voice and say thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
Some people raise their voice and just holler out, God be the glory.
Yeah.
God be the glory. Great things that he has done.
Yeah.
There are things that God does for us that we need to be able to tell somebody else.
Yeah.
And then you get a good hand wave on there.
Yeah.
Pursue him every day.
Yes.
Great is thy mercy. Every day.
Every day.
Every day.
Yes.
He gives us new mercies. So he wants us pursuing him every day. When you wake up in the morning, start going after Jesus.
Amen.
In the afternoon, go after Jesus. When you on the trail, going to wherever you're going, you just need to be going after
Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah.
Make sure whatever you're doing, you're still going after Jesus. You got to make a way out of your way to get to Jesus. You don't let anybody get in your way so that you can get to Jesus. You got to know what you're doing when you call in God's name so that you can get to Jesus. Pursuing God every day through your son, Jesus. You got to let God do the things that he'll do in your life because Jesus has paid it all. And all to him I owe. Sin and left the crimson stain, but he washed it through us. It don't matter where you've been. It don't matter what you've done. If you are going after Jesus, he'll cleanse you from your sins. He'll make your sins white as snow. God is ready to do a new thing in your life. All you got to do is go after Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I want to make sure that I'm living for Jesus. He is the one who made a way out of no way. God says, I'll be with you.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
But the Bible also tells us
Lord,
that Jesus didn't leave us powerless. Matthew 18 said that he came with all power.
All power.
And then he gave it to us. He said, you'll do greater things than following me.
Going
after me, you're going to do greater things. You ain't even seen the best that you can do if you're following, going after Jesus Christ. If you don't let the world get you torn up, the Bible says that the world had gone after him. But the reason that the world had gone after him was because they were seeing other people who were believers going after him. It wasn't just the miracle. It was the people who were his disciples who were following him too. And who dedicated themselves. Many of them left what they had and had left the things that they were doing in order to be able to follow him. And that dedication and the love that they had for Jesus is what made the world then begin to go after him. Because they went after him. What are you going to do? His triumph through tragedy. The doors of the church are open. We extend the invitation.